Without further ado, I'd like to pass the microphone to Gina for our next song, I Hear a Symphony. Thank you.
To you gave me Special groups of people in here, Ella Stratton from the Hans Foundation, which are our charity this year. We'll hear from her a little bit later about the Hans Foundation. And also Dr. Joseph Sellenhagen, who is from Heart and Vascular, and they are our major sponsor for this year. So our big support to the reason that we make this happen and provide a donation to the Hans Foundation. Now pass over to Mum.
So once our crew's finished setting up the stage, we're going to move on to a piece now from our lovely AUMO choir. They're going to be singing the piece called Some Nights, and they're going to be doing it a cappella tonight. So hope you enjoy the rest of the concert, and we'll be seeing you very shortly.
And feel free in between acts and speeches to just chat amongst yourselves. Thank you very much for coming, and yeah, we hope you have a wonderful night. Thank you very much. So today, the AUMO dance group is bringing you quite an energetic hip-hop performance, which is choreographed to some more recent pop tunes, which I'm sure you will probably recognise. So when they come out, please welcome them onto stage, and we hope you enjoy. Thank you.
wonderful friend, and you run them over ever since the stars on the end. All around the corner, cause I know you so well.
Yeah.
by Jane Lee and Samantha Young this year. So in just a minute, I'm going to hand over to my fellow co-chair, Marcus Carr, who is performing a very special piece on the piano, definitely by himself, entirely by himself, and not with anyone else. So thank you very much.
Thank you. So, as you heard from Georgia, we've got a piano piece coming up next. Normally we do a bit of a group thing where we all play, you know, taking turns one at a time. But this year I'm going to be doing it all by myself, nobody else at all, just me, no help, whole keyboard to myself. So, hope that sounds all right to you.
Keep music, please, Alicia. Thank you. Function from an end at raising money, and I'll let Ella talk a bit about the Has Foundation, what it is and what they do, so please make her very welcome.
Hello everyone, thank you all for having me here this evening, and a huge thank you to Georgia and the whole team behind this. What an amazing piece that just was with the piano, it was fantastic. We are extremely grateful. Yesterday they set the scene for us at our Mother's Day luncheon with a beautiful string quartet that played. We were extremely fortunate to have them come along, so thank you, because I didn't get a chance to actually speak to them yesterday because it was extremely busy, so please thank the guys who came along yesterday. I'm sure you've had a bit of a look in the program and read a little bit about Has Foundation. So Has is Hunter Alfred Stratton, who was our eldest son. He was born beautiful, normal baby boy, but unfortunately, within a few weeks, he started to present signs of seizures, and we ended up going down a medical path and a journey that was very tiresome, very heartbreaking, and extremely harrowing the whole family. But his tenacity and his strength and bravery, which we always called Superman, and that first song, it certainly, quite emotional. I got quite teary actually when you played that. It was really beautiful. And so he was our Superman, and he still is our Superman. And he endured quite a long journey of battling with his health. He didn't actually have a diagnosis. He was a bit of a mystery man with uncontrollable seizures. But in the end, he just wore out. He got very tired. So he passed away 8 years ago at the age of nearly 12. And after he passed away, we felt that we had years and years of living in a world caring for a physically disabled child that had given us a lot of knowledge about the world medically, and also being in palliative care for the last 3 years of his life. We learned so much about what these families need. So we decided in Hunter's honour that we would start a foundation to help these families and use that knowledge that we gained from caring for him to help support others. So the Has Foundation was born, and in 5 short years, we're not even 5 just yet, we've managed to raise great amounts of money to be able to help support. And the way that we feel that we could really be there for the families was the little touch points. So the palliative team at the Women's and Children's do an incredible, incredible job, but we help support them being able to deliver care packs to families. So we understand exactly what the families need and what they're going through. So our care packs are for the siblings, for the parents, for the child that's unwell. And we make sure that they're sent with all nurturing and practical items for when they're in hospital and going through the heartbreaking journey that they have ahead of them. We've also just delivered, as we do each year, 45 Mother's Day care packs to first-year bereaved mums. So just so that they know that there's someone there that understands and someone that knows that they're cared for and thought of in that first heartbreaking year of being without your child. We also deliver another 100 Christmas packs over Christmas time for families, and we make sure that all of the programs that we deliver are sent in a way that they're really nurtured and cared for. So all of the fundraising that we do goes directly to the families. We're a very, very small team at Has, and most of the time it's run from my kitchen table, because we try and do everything we can to give back to the families. It's been incredible being a part of something like this with these young, amazing students being so talented, being able to perform plus studying, and I feel extremely grateful that we can share awareness about palliative care and what that means to us as families. And these young, wonderful medical students are the future generations of doctors. So I believe that raising awareness about the importance, and if they could bring that amount of energy and joy and fun to all of the families in the future that they're going to care for, whichever field of medicine that they go into, I know that we're going to be in good hands. And the programs that we support, and our whole philosophy is to live for the moment. So I think these guys are doing a fantastic job tonight of showing us all how to live in the moment, enjoy the little things in life. And that's really what we're about at HAS, and what we try to focus on with the families that are coming to the end of life for their child. It's about those special moments and the living with their child. It's not about the end. So I think if everybody tonight is mindful and enjoys and lives for the moment, enjoying this beautiful concert, and thank you so much for having me here this evening, and enjoy the wonderful rest of the night. Thank you so much.
Website that really details exactly what they do. There's wonderful photos. They have a very new program coming out soon, which was announced yesterday, so please, they're very, very active. They're doing a lot of wonderful work for Adelaide and South Australian families. Please do look them up and see how you can get involved with volunteering or donating or just raising awareness about it. So thank you so much. Please give another round of applause to Ella. So our next and final act for our last group of performers for our first act before our interval is the Big Bed. So this is a wonderful group that I've been fortunate to be a part of since I joined medicine in 2018. It's a heck of a lot of fun. The rehearsals are pretty chaotic most of the time, but they bring usually a good amount of jazz and funk and a bit of fun to the concert. So tonight we are performing I Wish, Body and Soul, Gospel Joy. So these three pieces that vary in tone, rhythm and feel. And I really hope that you enjoy all three. After this we will have the interval. We'll have a 15-minute interval. Please feel free to wander outside, head to the toilet, buy some raffle tickets. But please enjoy the performances by our AUMO Big Band. Thank you.
you enjoyed the first half of our concert. We're going to be taking a short break now. Please feel free to head to the front of house and buy some more raffle tickets, as we'll be drawing the prizes in the second half.
So we have a 15-minute intermission. Keep an eye on your clocks, but you'll hear a lovely little ding and then come back on in for our second half. Thank you very much.
Please give them a round of applause.
Future Angus King on vocals, and 2-3 Adventure. And now these three pieces have been a lot of fun to rehearse, have been quite tricky, especially rhythmically at their percussion, but I think we've all come together and done a really wonderful job. So I'd like to take this moment to thank a few people that have been very important in Big Band, in Silas Koo and Savan Pereira. They are Big Band directors this year. They're both in fourth year. They both did mock OSCEs today, so practice exams today, and we're still up here ready to go for the concert tonight. So please give a round of applause to our Big Band directors, Saran and Silas. And also another special thank you to a couple of people that we are very grateful to. When we fall short of really key instruments, you know, we really want to build them up. So whether that's family or friends or other uni students. And this year we've been very grateful that we've received really the cream of the crop of musicians. We have not just, you know, gotten other musicians from different uni degrees, but gotten con musicians. So musicians who are playing the instrument at university to become professionals who have come and join us. So we have many in the orchestra, and I won't name them right now, but in Big Band we're very lucky. We have Carl and Marco, Carl on the bass and Marco on the drums, who have joined us. So we're very grateful. Please give those guys a hand. So please chat amongst yourselves until we're all ready to go, but I hope you enjoy the next act of Big Band. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
for this next piece, Angus King, and for our lovely small string ensemble. Round of applause.
Far away, far away. Fly with me.
next piece, just want to say a few thank yous, and really a brief thank you is not enough for the hard work that these people have done. So firstly, our backstage crew, these are the guys that you've seen quickly and calmly and professionally moving to stage between each set. So we've got Maynard. And for these guys, they just, you know, I've asked them to do it and they've very happily done it. And it means that instead of getting to relax between sets, they're up here ready to go for the entire performance, and they have been all day. So really a huge job. I want to thank Katja, Tammy, Shiva, Will. Thank you very much. Please give them a hand. Also want to say thank you to our instrument short and has just learnt the music straight away. So please give these guys a round of applause. To our sponsors, our major sponsor, Vascular and Heart, who will have a representative come up soon to draw the raffle, and our other sponsors, Presto, MIPS, UX, and 5MBS. Please give them a round of applause. I'd also like to say a massive thank you to someone who has supported AUMO since 2018. This person does it for free every year. Sure, they get their logo in our program and they get to photograph a few 21st because of it, but really, our photographer does far more than I think we give back to him. So Carl from Cyrus Vision photographs our concerts and has done since 2018, fully free, it's fully volunteering. And he is here from 9 a.m. till whenever we finish dress rehearsal, and he was here since 9 a.m. today, and he will be here until the concert finishes. And not only does he take the photos on those days, he then goes through them the next day and sends us, you know, the hand-picked ones that look good for our program. Without him, our programs would look nowhere near as professional as they do, and he does it all voluntarily. So when we can find him, he's up there, that's the way taking photos. You after the concert, so we'll find you afterwards after you've done all your photography. So please, another round of applause from Carl from Cyrus Vision.
All right, so as you may know, many of our AUMO members are 6 years, meaning this is our last ever year participating in AUMO concerts. So we're looking forward to being back sitting where you are now next year. But until then, we're going to celebrate with a special 6 year item. So this year we have 6 years from all four of our main ensemble groups, orchestra, choir, big band, and dance. So we've got a special item to show off our individual talents, and that's the Libertango by Astor, Piazzolla. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Orchestra. So the next two pieces we are doing are Pictures at an Exhibition and Deliver Us. And we'll speak about the second piece, Deliver Us. That is an amazing, wonderful piece from the 1998 film Prince of Egypt, which follows the tale of Moses from the Bible. And this has been arranged by Gina Lang, who is our first violin. We hope you really enjoy this piece as we're joined by the vocalists. But firstly, we'll be playing Pictures at an Exhibition, so please give a hand for the orchestra.
Thank you.
life where, you know, it's time to pass the baton on, so to speak, and tonight is one of those times. So I'd like to welcome Gina to the stage. Please make her feel welcome. Thank you.
Thank you.
But before we finish, there's a few more people we have to thank. As you're probably aware, running a concert like this is more than just one person's job. In fact, it's more than just two people's job, which is why we couldn't have done it without the help of our fabulous AUMO committee, who we'll now give a shout out to. So we've got our secretary, Alicia. Our treasurer, Chris. Our music director, Gina.
Our two publications officers who are somewhere in the audience because they're both doing 50 this year and one of them is living in Clare, but designed this beautiful program for us, Rebecca and Anne. Please give them a clap. We all have sponsorship officer. Our media, marketing and membership officers, Sonny and Alma. Our events and logistic coordinators who are running around, here they are, Kutcher and Tammy.
Then we've got all of our ensemble leaders, so our orchestra managers, Danan and Kianan. Our big band leaders, Silas and Saran. Our dance leaders, Jang and Samantha. Our choir leader, Angus. And then our whole arranging team who've brought you much of the beautiful music you've heard tonight. So Gina, Alicia, Chris, Constance, Sunny, Saran.
And Marcus.
And last of all, we'd like to thank all of you for your support, for coming to watch us today. If not for you, we'd be playing to an empty hall. Of course, there's not much point to that. So we really appreciate you guys being here. All of the support you've showed us and really your generosity in buying tickets, raffle tickets, programs and so on, all going towards such a fabulous cause. So I really hope you've enjoyed the evening and we're going to finish off with our medley for all the combined ensembles called Music Through the Ages. So thank you.
Thank you.
Let's hear it one more time for all our performers tonight.
Otherwise, everyone have a lovely night and a safe drive home. Thank you.